Godfrey Mazune, 47 years and a resident of Kira, a Kampala suburb, is a prostate cancer survivor. Mazune discovered he had prostate cancer at the time he was attending to his deceased father, who was also battling against prostate cancer. He shares his story of the battle against the disease.
I was attending to him. The medical people advised us, who are children, to him to do tests here and there, so that we know our status with the prostate cancer. So in that time we somehow busy and would not do that then. So we had to keep on attending to him. But after some time, we had to have a break when he was at home and find out about our statuses. But it took us time to gather efforts, to gather strength and go and retest, because all the time we're so busy.
Given the family history of his dad developing prostate cancer, Mazune, together with his siblings, were advised by health workers to test for prostate cancer. They took an initial test called the prostate-specific antigen test, and the results doubled the normal range of 0.4, which indicated a high suspicion of prostate cancer. He later continued to take other tests.
After seeing that the PSAs were doubling, everywhere you go, I used to spend 2-3 months and go. The doctor told me, now do the monitoring and we see. So I did the monitoring. You monitor when you go for a test. You go for a PSA test. So when I did the monitoring, the doctor told me, now what we're seeing, we should go for another test that is more than this one, which is called the biopsy.
At the time Mazune received the biopsy, his dad had succumbed to prostate cancer, which was rather devastating.
The doctor interpreted to me and told me, still, I have to do another test. So he wrote to me a request to do MRI. Doing the MRI just so takes some time. You do the results, you do the test, takes some time, and then after that time, you go back. After going back, they give you the results, which you still have to take to the doctor for interpretation.
He had to undergo a surgery to remove the cancerous tumor. He's now under observation to determine whether the cancer cells were completely eliminated. Mazune advises fellow men to regularly check for prostate cancer. He encourages those battling with the disease not to give up but adhere to treatment.
I would urge them to go for testing. If you can't afford the testing, wherever you see a camp and they're doing it for free, please do go and test.
Uganda ranks second in Africa in prostate cancer cases with 37.1 cases per 100,000 men. Professor Michael Grace Kawoya, a radiologist specialized in investigating prostate diseases at Ernest Cook Ultrasound Research Institute in Mengo, describes what prostate cancer is. Professor Kawoya highlights the burden of prostate cancer in the country and urges the public to be vigilant.
You could say that the country sees about 20 to 25 cases, new cases of prostate cancer in per week, which makes about 1,000 cases of prostate cancer in a year, or slightly more in the whole country. And we also know that prostate cancer kills slightly over 1,000 men in this country every year. So you could say that it is a big problem. It is a big problem. And for that reason, we have to be watching out.
Professor Kawoya further explains the different ways through which prostate cancer is diagnosed. He further explains that when the disease is discovered to be in the first and second stages, it is treated and therefore curable.
People think that when you biopsy something suspicious, then the cancer spreads, but that is not true. That is spread by people who really don't understand much about how to. They are not medical people. There is no proof, at least for prostate cancer, that when you do biopsy, the prostate cancer spreads. No, you only help in finding it out early. And the earlier it is found out in the early stages, stage one or stage 2, latest stage 3, then you can have a cure. But stage 1 and stage 2, you can be cured. So it's important that you subject yourself, you allow yourself to be biopsied.
Prostate cancer in the early stages does not exhibit any signs and symptoms because the gland is still small. The signs and symptoms present in advanced stages. It is for this reason that all men aged 40 and above should start checking periodically.
And so we do know, yes, we know that prostate cancer, you could say, is a symptomless. It doesn't have any symptoms. And that's why it's important that every man after the age of 40, I should say, should start doing a PSA, which is a screening test, so that you have a baseline. You have your so-called beginning level, and anything which starts to rise after that, that should be suspicious.
Signs of prostate cancer include lower abdominal pain, persistent back pain or pelvic pain, blood in the urine or semen, frequent urination, especially at night, painful ejaculation, weak flow of urine, difficulty passing or controlling urine, painful or burning during urination, and erectile dysfunction. Professor Kawai explains the different treatment modalities for prostate cancer and how each works. He further emphasizes the need to screen for prostate cancer early so as to increase the chances of cure.
Be what it may, if it's the early stage, then there it would have to be surgery. And with surgery, they remove the entire prostate, and but they remove it in such a way that you still retain your ability to hold your urine. And so they do that very carefully. And also your ability to function as a man.
Of the 14,529 new cancer cases that the country registered among men in 2020, a total of 2,375 people were newly diagnosed with prostate cancer, which translates to 16.3%. According to the GlobalCan 2020 report, of the 14,529 new cancer cases that the country registered among men in 2020, a total of 2,375 people were newly diagnosed with prostate cancer, which translates to 16.3%. The same report reveals that in the same year, about 1,366 men succumbed to the disease, hence the need to care. Reports compiled by Agnes Chotalingerire for the news.